Where members of parliament from the Greater Masaka region have given the Minister for Security only 12 hours to deploy heavy security within the district to end a series of killings by machete-wielding assailants, which have now claimed at least 20 people in a space of 2 months. MPs vow to mobilize the people to protest and protect themselves if the presence of security is not felt within a Masaka district. Our correspondent has more.
Another body of an individual has been hacked to death in Masaka to bring the number of people killed in the similar manner in Greater Masaka to 20. The situation has put the entire sub-region on tension, including members of parliament who have addressed the press at parliament today.
The issue is too worse, and security has been actually reluctant, like everybody has mentioned, to curb the situation. Apparently, in Chabogo, the previous two days, two people were massacred again. And unfortunately, police came and surrounded the whole village and docked it at Kinoni Police Station and Mbirizi without segregating the knows and the don't knows.
The series of these murders have no proper direction. You could not say they are looking for this particular person or the other, but they are singling out people that are innocent. And there is not much that the world needs from them. My humble appeal to the security office, to the security forces, is if you can patrol a village during the daytime where there is no death, why not throw in patrols, foot patrols, during the day and night?
We are requesting the security body to come to Masaka, because Masaka city is the center for Greater Masaka. It's where all these MPs you are seeing here, that's where we are joining. So please, we are requesting the security to be more alert.
Led by the leader of opposition, Matthias Mpunga, who represents Nyendo Mukungwe Division, Greater Masaka MPs have given the Ministry of Security only 12 hours to have security presence in the area.
We are here to demand for the presence of government and security in this area. We are to demand that the Minister of Security, the Minister of Internal Affairs, do take up their responsibility to the communities in Masaka, that raise and assure the people that they are in charge. I am very sure that you did follow communication from security that asked the people to raise vigilantes themselves.
This morning, the leader of opposition guided us to the speaker, and we had a meeting with the Minister of Security, General Jim. They have assured us that they are going to give the situation in Masaka priority, and we are asking them that it is very crucial, it is of essence that all the security organs are visible in Masaka and on the ground doing the work.
They dismiss allegations tagging this part of terror to land wranglers, saying the problem is beyond that.
The most disturbing development from these escalations is that for all the array of security groups that purport to operate in the area and the country at large, none of them is telling the people exactly what they have heard, seen or touched.
The leader of opposition accuses police in Masaka for taking bribes to release the few suspects arrested in connection to the murder.
One of the persons arrested from Katoke village by the police, for him to be released on police bond,
yes,
he had to part with 3 million. And I'm asking police authority to go and investigate their officers in Inkoni who took a ransom from one of the citizens who was arrested.
Legislators from Masaka confessed fearing for their lives, saying they are being trailed by unknown people.
Even us as leaders, we are worried because there seems to be some movements around us that are threatening our security. Last week I noticed in the area of my residence here in Kampala, borders doing surveillance on my place of residence.
MPs also want government to take charge of the burial arrangements of the victims. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.